This video will be a compilation of super easy step-by-step instructions on how to start Home Assistant on Windows machine using Docker, or in other words, how to run Home Assistant container. But there is more. I'll show you how to update your Home Assistant when there is a new release and how to implement an automatic health check mechanism. If you don't have Home Assistant yet, this is a great way to finally get one and join in one of the fastest growing communities in the smart home world. On the other hand, if you already have Home Assistant, you can use this method to quickly spin a new test installation where you can start experimenting safely. I'll also share which is the one and only drawback of this method in my humble opinion. Just to mention that everything is free and it should work on any Windows version that is still in support and on any recent Intel or AMD processor from the last 5 to even 10 years that support virtualization instructions. Without further ado, let's start this video. First thing that is needed is a working Docker application. For that, I'll go to docker.com website where I can download Docker. I'm using the standard Docker installation and I'm accepting everything that is recommended. Basically, I'm just clicking on the next button until the installation is finished. After that, I'll click on the Windows Start button and I'll search for Docker and I'll click on it to start it. This is what I wanted to see at the end. A green whale saying that Docker Engine is running. This means that everything is fine with the Docker installation. By the way, if you get any warnings about WSL2, that is Windows Subsystem for Linux that Docker is using, just follow the official Microsoft instructions to resolve the issue. And you can find the link to these instructions in the video description. Next, I'll create a new empty folder named Home Assistant in my C drive on my Windows machine. I'm going to use this folder for the Home Assistant configuration. Be careful here, if you want to replicate the steps that follows without any modification, make the same folder inside your C drive and name it Home Assistant. Exactly the same way, all lowercase, without space or other special characters. After that, go to this GitHub link that is available in the video description and either download the file as zip and unzip it or copy its contents and paste it in an empty notepad. Then name that file docker-compose.yml and save it in your Home Assistant folder in drive C. Then click on the Windows Start button and type cmd to run the Windows command prompt. Enter inside the Home Assistant folder that we created earlier and in which we saved the docker-compose.yml file and type docker-compose space up. This command will read the docker-compose.yml file and will execute the instructions inside. It will download Home Assistant image, it will create a Docker container, it will map the Home Assistant config folder to the C Home Assistant folder, it will set the time zone, it will expose the port 8123 where Home Assistant is running, and it will implement the health check mechanism, so at the end you have a fully working Home Assistant. To check that everything is working, you can open the Docker app where you can see that Home Assistant container is running and you can open the web interface. After 90 seconds, because we set that time in our docker-compose.yml file, you can open a new command prompt and you can type docker container ls command. And you see that our automatic health check is running and the Home Assistant container is healthy. If for some reason localhost on port 8123 is not accessible, this healthy status will not be shown here. One quick remark here, don't delete the docker-compose.yml file as we're going to use it for the future updates. Another quick remark, instead of using docker-compose.yml file, you can achieve the same result but without the health check by using a docker run command. You can get this command from the video description and you just have to paste it in the command prompt instead of docker-compose up command. So, this is another method which may be even easier. To demonstrate you that, I'll stop and delete the HA container that docker-compose up created from the Docker app. Of course, this can be done from the command prompt, but using the Docker app is more visual friendly. Then I'll open a new command prompt and I'll paste the docker run command that I copied from the video description. So far, so good. We now know two ways to start Home Assistant on Windows. And when Home Assistant is started, it is time for onboarding, which is super easy process. You just have to type a username and password You can then name your Home Assistant installation, set a location, country, language, currency, and stuff like that. Then you can optionally opt in for the anonymous Home Assistant statistics. The system will also try to auto-discover some devices and integrations nearby. And finally, you're in. You can now freely start using Home Assistant. Every month there is one new major release, and during that month, usually more than 5 minor versions are also released. So, updating your Home Assistant is an important and regular task. With Home Assistant running on Docker, or Home Assistant container, which is the official name of this kind of installation, the update process is easy. The Home Assistant container installation on Windows that we just did can be executed almost the same way on Mac and Linux operating systems. Just few minor modifications in the config folder mapping are needed. This type of installation have almost everything, and it is suitable for everyone, from just testing type of installation to serious production environment where you can lose money if Home Assistant is down. The only thing that is missing here is the Home Assistant add-on store, from where you can install some useful add-ons with just one click. Most of these add-ons are coming pre-configured and ready to use, so they are great if you are looking for convenience and functionality. On the other hand, you may never need these apps in the Home Assistant add-on store, or you can manually install them. So that can be considered as a plus or minus, depending on the point of view. To understand more about the different installation type of Home Assistant, you can register for my upcoming webinar, where I'm talking exactly about that. Which Home Assistant installation types have add-on store, and what are their pros and cons? It will help you find a method to start Home Assistant that is best for you. The webinar is completely free, and you can register from the link that is shown on the screen. I'll also add the link in the video description. And back to the current Home Assistant installation type. If for some reason Home Assistant container is not your thing, and you want to remove and clean everything, that can be easily done. Just delete the Home Assistant container from the Docker application, then delete the Home Assistant image, and you can even remove Docker from the Windows at remove programs. With Home Assistant container or not, you can download my smart home glossary if some of the smart home terms and abbreviations are not so clear for you. It will help you because it is full of simple but useful explanation of these terms. The glossary is completely free, and it is in a form of a PDF document, so you can use it offline on any device you wish. Link can be found in the video description as well as on the screen. Thank you for watching. I'm Kiryu. See you next week. Bye.